Ladies and gentlemen, the Arshak Sirunyan Quartet.
Welcome. Thank you all for being here tonight. Fred, let's begin. Rain in Charleston. Sounds familiar? We all know what happens when it rains in Charleston, especially downtown. Well, this picture doesn't show Market Street or Grove Street, the floods. Here I am, you see. But to me, this has a different message. It's clear that the storm has passed, the sky is clearing out, the sun is about to come out. And it has that sense of new hope, new beginning, refresh, everything will be fine. It's okay that we're just a few feet above sea level. The artist is Thomas Fransioli, American artist, born in 1906. He was a practicing architect, but after he returned from service from overseas during World War II, he turned his attention to painting. In the late 1940s, Fransioli was commissioned by Collier's magazine to create a series of 30 large-scale cityscapes of American cities. The paintings were to be published as cover illustrations over a five-year period. Although it was not among the cities featured, Fransioli traveled through Charleston while on this assignment and captured sketches of Laura Street that ultimately resulted in this painting. Right, the tune is also called Rain in Charleston.
Thank you.
one is Search. The author is William Halsey, American, born in 1915, Charleston native. He's achieved wide recognition as one of the premier artists of the South's modernist movement. Early in his career, Halsey created landscapes, still lifes, and portraits, but he is best known for his abstract expressionist works, his paintings. Known to agonize over the titles of his painting, Halsey carefully selected words and phrases that afford insight into his artistic thought processes. He originally titled this work Four Characters of Search of an Identity, but crossed that out and just left it as Search. So, as you can see, it's red, lots of red. To me, red color is it's about extremes. Passion, seduction, anger, violence, adventure, also. Our prehistoric ancestors saw red as the color of fire and blood, energy and primal life forces, and most of the red symbols today arises from powerful association in the past. So we're going to try to recreate this heat and energy that's coming from this picture. It's going to be intense. So, we need to lock it. All right, so Search. So he's also called Search. Research Grant. All right, I'm going to hand this over to Robert.
Okay. I'm a much simpler man than Arshak. The museum has this great collection of these drawings that are illustrations of the libretto of the Porgy and Bess. They're kind of hidden away. I don't even think Arshak saw them when he was looking through the museum. So I kind of cheated. Some of you may know I wrote a big band show based on Porgy and Bess. So it included the tune I Love You Porgy, which seems very appropriate for this picture. This is Porgy and Bess embracing here. And so it's sort of inspired by the John Coltrane Quartet. He had several of these sort of rubato ballads that went into swing in the middle and then back into rubato. And so it's got some of the darkness of the situation that Porgy and Bess found themselves in. And then at the end, it gets very operatic. So, yeah. Thank you.
The next one is called The Green Fan, painted in 1912 by Robert Henry. Robert Henry in the early 20th century was an influential leader of a group of realist artists who came to known as the Ashen School. These artists worked in a variety of styles and subjects that were united in their focus of urban realism and capturing truth and vitality through their work. Henry was a prolific portrait painter. Often picnic sitters, he deemed his eye. He had a great interest in Spanish culture and painted the Green Fan during a visit to Spain, Toledo. So, the tune we're gonna play is called Imperfect Pearl, which I'm cheating to, because I wrote it years ago. Anyway, but when I was browsing the gallery and I saw this picture, it might sound weird, but it felt like that I knew her. Because in my album that was released in 2014 called Hoodman's Blind, there is a female persona in the story, which is based on true facts, historic facts. And she has a similar characteristics. I wish I saw her before doing the album, because I would do everything to include this painting in my booklet. Why? Because there are a lot of actually artists who generously gave me their permission to use their art in the booklet. So an album is available to pick up if you'd like. And also I recommend reading the story and looking at the artwork when you listen to the music. But also Imperfect Pearl is translated from Portuguese, which means actually translated from Baroque. If you don't know, Baroque is a style that flourished in early 17th, 18th century. Not only music style, it's art, architecture, and I tried to incorporate some of the Baroque style in the music. So yeah, this is Imperfect Pearl, and art is The Green Fan. Enjoy. Thank you. song called Gate of Wire, painted in 1957 by Chevis Clark. Chevis Clark was born in Charleston, South Carolina in 1922. After serving in World War, he went on to graduate from Atlanta School of Art. Clark was a designer and illustrator for US Navy from 58 to 73. So there is not much to say about this picture. I remember when I moved here 2 years ago, of course with the care store and props of the downtown, so the beautiful, gorgeous houses. But the most stunning was, of course, the ironworks, the fences, the gates. And this picture says it all. It was just, my favorite is the Routledge House. I don't know about yours, but it's just stunning. All right, so this is Gates of Iron. Again, thank you all for being here tonight. Once again, Robert Lewis on saxophone.
Thank you.